given that with delight and tenderness they may know each other in love. And through the joy of their bodily union, may strengthen the union of their hearts and lives. It is given as the foundation of family life in which children may be born and nurtured.
Revealed his glory, and his disciples believed in him. This is the word.
Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
by your presence and strengthened by your grace. May they bring comfort and confidence to each other in faithfulness and trust. May the hospitality of their home bring refreshment and joy to all around. May their love overflow to neighbours in need. God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love, defending on every side and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you this day and always. Amen.
Thank you. decision comes quickly. It's going to be here a long while. Right, as you've just been told, I'm Richard. Hello, everyone. My name's Richard, but like most dads, my other name is the banker. I must admit, Pam and I really didn't think this we would ever see this day. Not because of COVID, but at one time we thought Lindsay was a confirmed single. But we're delighted, you know, the day has arrived. Even if this is the third time of asking because of COVID, not for any other reason. First of all, I'd like to thank you all for coming. Many of you have travelled a long way. We've already had a lovely ceremony, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the day and the weekend. We couldn't have a better setting, in my opinion, and the weather's really helped as well. Over the past week or so, Pam and I have been looking back, and as you probably know, that Paul and Lindsay do a lot of walking, especially in the Lake District. This is hard to believe when you think back to Lindsay's childhood. When she was small and walking home to the shop with Pam, she didn't like the uphill part of the big trip home, and was always complaining her knees were breaking. How things have changed. After university, Lindsay worked in the charity sector for quite a while, including with Childline and the World Guide Girl Guiding, where she got the travel bug, leading projects on girls' welfare in India and Africa. We're very proud of her service and achievements, also being involved in guiding from childhood. She loves travelling, and I think she has convinced Paul that there are some great places to go hiking further afield than 50 miles from Glossop, even in the USA, but he thinks Yanks are stupid. We've known Paul now for about 10 years, and we're so pleased to welcome him to our family. He's a good solid Manchester lad, having the good sense not to support the Reds. Well, I suppose it's too much to ask for him to support the Canaries. That's my lot.
There's only one support of the Canaries in this tent.
Hands up, Norwich City supporters.
There's a couple.
Norwich City.
Just careful, you might get thrown out. Paul, though, is quite a discerning type, though, you know. I believe on their first date, Lindsay ordered sausage and mash. Paul immediately decided, this is the girl for me. She eats proper food. I don't think either of them will be bossing the marriage, but I have a couple of words of advice for you, Paul. Whenever you're wrong, admit it. Whenever you're right, shut up. Secondly, forget your wedding anniversary once. You'll remember it for the rest of your life. Looking round, it's great to see so many friends and family, friends of Lindsay, friends of Paul, friends of ourselves. And I look forward to meeting many of you who I know by name but have never met. I'd like to mention just two people in particular, though. They've been Lindsay's friends since the first days at play school or primary school. Emma is here today, but sadly Natasha, who intended to fly in from Australia, is not allowed to come. Unfortunately, my elder brother, Robin, is not able to make the journey from Norfolk, but has sent his good wishes. There are several others who are also unable to attend, but I'm sure their thoughts are with us today. Finally, Pam and I should like to thank Paul's family, Lorna in particular, for welcoming Lindsay into their family. I know how much she appreciates it and how much she gets on with you all. Lorna and all of you, thank you most sincerely. I think someone's hoping that I'll sit down in this. These other four pages, so I have to wait for another day. So I have one last thing to do. Please raise your glasses. Hold on. They forgot me. Andrew, who you got one? Please raise your glasses. So the newlyweds. Paul and Lindsay. Please enjoy the rest of your day.
Thanks to Richard for his kind words. Well, we got there in the end. Thanks to everyone for coming here today. As Richard said, it's like the third attempt, so thank you for coming. So there's a picture on the table, and this is a picture of my dad. In 1976, recently married my mum. I was on the way, oh, I think I've just arrived by that time. I just started a new job, having been made redundant, and the last one. So despite having taken all this responsibility, he's still smiling, which is why it's one of my favourite pictures of him. Both him and my mother gave me a great upbringing. Unfortunately, we lost my dad to cancer 10 years ago. Losing a parent isn't easy, but sometimes as one door closes, another one opens. And shortly after losing Dad, I met Lindsay. The last thing that my dad did for me was advise me to pursue a career in IT. And if he provided the roadmap, it was Lindsay who helped me reach my destination. Lindsay had to put up with the trials and tribulations of both me being a mature student, and then later on embarking on a new career as a software engineer. Been a rock throughout all of it. It's fair to say that sometimes the in-laws get a lot of bad press. The first piece of advice Richard gave me was, Lindsay is always right. Following this advice has really made my life so much easier. It's also good to have someone, a fellow City fan, even though he's not a Man City fan, he's still a City fan, to discuss the football results with. Being an Auburn lad, I quite like to meet Pies, a massive fan of Pies. Every time Pam and Richard visit, Pam brings me a Leeson's award-winning Melton Mowbray port pie. She even brought one this weekend where Richard went on a special trip to go and get it. What more could I ask for in-laws? Sound advice and a supply of award-winning pies. Yeah, any better than that. Organising an event like this requires a lot of work, and over the past year or so, people have contributed in many different ways. Paper stuff, baked wedding cakes, stored the wedding dress, missed at least 16 trains trying to collect a spruce machine from Manchester, Wilson. Organised fishing trips to Beaumaris, looked after Silver the dog in church, organised a wedding car, gave us advice, sorted the venue, Sarah and Lee from Windy Harbour have been brilliant. Organised the parking outside the church, although it might have been slightly illegal. Organised flowers and set decorations above the church and this venue. Put up logs for table decorations. Helped sort the bridesmaid dresses, being a better best man than I ever was, even though I'm not ready to speak yet. But lastly, thanks to Lindsay for planning everything with meticulous attention that would put Hannibal Smith from the A-team to shame. And more importantly, being agreeing to be my wife. And with that, like a toast to the group, to the bride, please. By Hannibal. We've got presents for the bridesmaids and the groomsmen, so at some point we've got them.
introduced myself to most of you as last time we're in a room together. You were attending my wedding, and Paul was my best man. For the Gilbert party, I'm Rob, Paul's younger brother. I had the harder paper round. Unfortunately, Paul got to use the most humorous material in his best man speech. But one story Paul missed or chose not to remember was a great start we got while racing our sidecar motocross bike in Buxton. After receiving a pep talk from Dad on how to get a good start, we bumped up to get off the line and have a good race. On the start line, the 15-second ball goes up, the 5-second ball goes up, and we're off. Mid-pack, not a bad start. Then we got to the first corner and something was wrong. The bike didn't turn. I looked to my side where Paul should be stood, and he was not there. I looked to the start line, and he was still there. Waving his arms in a rage. So I turned the bike round, picked him up, and all I got was shouted at him, slapped over the helmet. Great times racing with Paul and the family. So many fond memories. Still to this day, I don't know how Paul ended up on the start line. Apart from the racing and the normal brotherly ups and downs, growing up with Paul as my older brother, with the easier paper round, has always been a pleasure. And the addition of Lindsay to our life and family has only made it better. Paul, as a boy, teenager and a man, has always done things properly. This came from Dad's do it right or not at all approach. This explains Paul not being satisfied with a career in the RAF or a well-paid job in an expanded engineering company. No, Paul decides to go back to school at the tender age of 35. This decision was to do it right or not at all. And thankfully, it's paid off for Paul. We're all proud that not only did he get a degree, he's gone on to progress in a career that he set out to do. Lindsay has played her part in this, supporting Paul through his academic time and listening to his moans about fellow students. Paul, you're a lucky man to find Lindsay, who you share so many interests, hobbies and pleasures, and we are lucky to have you both as auntie and uncle for Robert and Jensen, who you pass on your interests for the outdoors and spend fun times together. Finally, we get to spend this day together and you both look fantastic. I'd like to thank Paul for asking me to be his best man and give praise to Lindsay for her hard work putting this wedding together. I'd also like to thank the bridesmaids, Tilly and Isabel, over there. Please raise your glasses to the bride and groom. May the roof above you never fall in and you both never fall out.
Your hair looks a bit uneven.
It's right. That's why I put the trainers on.
If you want to bring your cameras round to the front, guys, anybody who wants to take photographs before I get the dance going.
I never thought I'd miss you half as much as I do.
Yeah, he's sure.